Hello everyone, this is Ankur Chaudhary, and in this video I'll be covering important current affairs from India and across the world from 1st June 2018 till 15th June 2018. Let's begin. So these are the broad areas that I'll be covering current affairs from. Let's start with awards and honors. Firstly, the Chandrabhaga beach on the Konark coast of Odisha became Asia's first beach to get the blue flag certification. The blue flag certification is given annually by the Foundation for Environmental Education for beaches and marine spots across the world, which have been very well maintained, are clean and provide good facilities for tourists visiting there. Next, Mr. Zubeen Garg, he's an actor and a singer, would be honored with the Hero to Animals Award by PETA India, that is People for Ethical Treatment of Animals. I repeat, People for Ethical Treatment of Animals, for his recent appeal to end animal sacrifice at the Kamakhya Temple in Assam. So, annually, during the Bihu festival in Assam, there are large number of animal sacrifices that take place in the famous Kamakhya Temple located in Assam. So, Zubeen Garg, he protested against this practice, and for that reason he was awarded by PETA India. Next, the Indian star cricketer Yuvraj Singh was honored with the Most Inspiring Icon of the Year for Social Welfare Award by the Dadasaheb Phalke International Film Festival. Next, India cricket captain Virat Kohli was presented with the prestigious Polly Umrigar Award for the Best International Cricketer 2016-17 at the BCCI Awards held in Bengaluru. Also in the same awards, Miss Harmanpreet Kaur and Smriti Mandhana, these are two players in the International Women's Cricket Team of India, they were recipients of the award for Best International Cricketer Women for the year 2016 and 2017 seasons respectively. Next, President Ram Nath Kovind presented the Santokhba Humanitarian Award to Nobel Laureate Mr. Kailash Satyarthi and Space Scientist A.S. Kiran Kumar, who is the former chairperson or chairman of the ISRO, that is Indian Space Research Organization. Next, some news from business. Firstly, Ms. Divya Surya Devara, an Indian-American woman, was named the Chief Finance Officer, CFO, of the US's largest automaker, that is GM or General Motors, thus becoming the first woman CFO in the auto industry. This is very important, especially for BBA entrance examinations. Next, Mr. Mahesh Kumar Jain, who is currently MD and CEO of IDBI Bank, was appointed as one of the deputy governors of the RBI. So RBI, that is the Reserve Bank of India, is headed by the governor. Under the governor, there are four deputy governors, right? So Mr. Mahesh Kumar Jain is one of the four deputy governors. Next, NTPC Limited adopted the iconic Char Minar in Hyderabad under the Swachh Iconic Places Projects of India. This is part of a special drive under the center's Swachh Bharat mission. So the Swachh Iconic Places projects, right, it was launched. So in phase one, there were 10 iconic sites like Taj Mahal, etc., which were shortlisted. Next, phase two, another 10 sites were selected. And this is part of phase three, wherein another 10 sites have been, historical sites have been selected under this project. So making the total to 30 historical sites coming under this project. Now, under this project, central PSUs or public sector undertakings or Government of India undertakings, they are adopting certain these historical sites. So, for example, NTPC has adopted the Char Minar. Now, NTPC would be contributing for the upkeep of Char Minar monument as part of its CSR activities, that is corporate social responsibilities. Next, Tata Motors Limited signed an MOU. MOU is nothing but an agreement with the government of Maharashtra for deployment of 1000 e-vehicles or electrical vehicles across its range of passenger and commercial vehicles in the state. Next, some news from politics. Firstly, Mr. Piyush Goyal, the Union Minister of Railways and Coal, launched two new mobile apps, that is Rail Madad, Madad is help in Hindi, and Menu on Rails to ease the travelling experience of the commuters. So there are a large number of mobile apps that are being launched by the Government of India. Next, the Union Government constituted a technical committee under the chairmanship of former Chief Statistician of India, that is Mr. TCA Anant, to bring in more transparency in job data calculation and presentation. Next, World Bank approved rupees 6,000 crores for Atal Bhujal Yojana. Atal Bhujal Yojana, which is a central scheme of Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. Right? So the Atal Bhujal Yojana. Bhujal stands for, so Bhu stands for earth or ground. Jal, of course, stands for water. So Bhujal is nothing but groundwater. Right? So this is a scheme which is for which the nodal agency is the Ministry of Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. The objective of the scheme is to ensure effective and sustainable utilization of groundwater in India. It's focused mainly on seven states which are having less groundwater, or rather are groundwater stressed. Next, the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare launched the Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan. The Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan from 1st June to 31st July 2018. The Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan will be undertaken in 25 villages with more than 1000 population each. So the Krishi Kalyan Abhiyan, basically the idea is to aid, advise and assist various farmers in the country on how to improve the productivity of their crops. Next, the Government of India launched affordable biodegradable sanitary napkins priced at rupees 250 per pad, which will be sold under the Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana. So the Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana, this is a national level campaign launched by the Department of Biotechnologies. These departments and nodal ministries for various important schemes, these are also important, right? So in this particular Pariyojana, the nodal department is Department of Biotechnology. The idea is to provide affordable and good quality medicines to all citizens of the country under this scheme. Generally, generic medicines are made available in government-run chemist shops. Next, Government of India set up an executive committee under the chairmanship of Prime Minister Narendra Modi to spread Mahatma Gandhi's legacy among the people at national and international level. Next, economy and finance. Firstly, Gujarat topped the Niti Aayog's Composite Water Management Index. Gujarat is followed by Madhya Pradesh, then Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Maharashtra on the same index. Now the Composite Water Management Index, it has ranked states in terms of effectiveness or the efficiency with which water is utilized by the states. Next, poor handling of air pollution abatement and forest protection measures saw India slip to 177th position in green rankings this year from its 141st position 2 years ago. In the latest Global Environmental Performance Index, this is important, these rankings were released on the sidelines of the World Economic Forum meet in Davos, Switzerland. Now this is a great cause of concern for the country that it has slipped more than 30 places in the last 2 years, and it is now part of the last five nations, because this ranking assessed only 180 countries. So India is placed at 177. Next, India was ranked 136th among 163 countries in Global Peace Index. This is important. It is prepared by Sydney-based international think tank, that is Institute for economics and peace. This index is topped by Iceland, then there's New Zealand, Portugal, Austria, and then Denmark. The top three rankers are always important in such international rankings. Next, the Union Finance Minister set up a committee to examine the possibility of setting up an asset reconstruction company or an asset management company to fast track resolution of stressed assets. Punjab National Bank's non-executive chairman Sunil Mehta will be heading the panel. Now, I'm sure most of you must have been reading the newspapers and are frequently coming across the problem of non-performing assets or stressed assets in the Indian banking sector. So basically what these assets are the loans that the banks have given to various industrialists, and those industrialists are not paying them back. Now, when the stressed assets or the non-performing assets of a particular bank go up, then the bankers become cautious and they stop lending further or giving out further loans to other perhaps genuine industrialists. What that does is it negatively impacts the growth rates in the country because financing is not available to genuine businessmen. Now, the idea of creating a separate asset reconstruction company is that this separate company, which will be separate from the banks, it will take over all this NPA and free the balance sheets of the banks so that the banks can go ahead and lend further to a genuine businessman. As far as these NPAs and stressed assets are concerned, certain professionals will be recruited or engaged to resolve the crisis, right? So the idea is to create a separate company to handle these stressed assets so that the banks are free to lend again. Next, the RBI launched Financial Literacy Week across the country with customer protection as its main theme. Next, we look at some people making the news. Firstly, Abdul Fattah al-Sisi was sworn in for a second four-year term in office as the president of Egypt at a time when the country is facing massive security and economic crisis. Next, Mr. Anthony Bourdain, the United States celebrity chef and television personality, passed away at the age of 61 years. He was a best-selling food, fiction and non-fiction author. Next, Mr. Arvind Saxena, a 1978 Indian Postal Services officer, was appointed as the acting chairman of the UPSC. UPSC is the Union Public Service Commission and conducts various recruitments for the central government, including that of IAS and IPS officers. Next, the Union government constituted a group of eminent persons to study the Special Economic Zone SEZ policy of India. Now, the SEZ policy has not been very successful in the country as compared to other countries. So that is why this policy is under review. Now, this group will be headed by industrialist Baba Kalyani. Baba Kalyani carries a lot of experience with himself. He is the former CMD of a company called Bharat Forge. It is one of the largest forging companies of the world. Next, Mr. Giuseppe Conte, an academic and political novice, was sworn in as the new Prime Minister of Italy. Next, Foreign Minister of Ecuador, Maria Fernanda Espinosa, was elected President of the 73rd United Nations General Assembly. Next, Mr. Pedro Sanchez of the Spanish Socialist Worker Party was officially sworn in as the new Prime Minister of Spain. Next, S. Ramesh was appointed as the new chairman of the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs. Now, this is the body which is the apex or the highest body making decisions related to collection of indirect taxes in the country like GST. Next, S. Sundari Nanda, a 1988 batch Indian Police Service officer, was appointed as the first woman DGP. DGP is Director General of Police and is the highest functionary of police in a state or a UT. So, Ms. Nanda becomes the first woman DGP of the Union Territory of Puducherry. Next, Shahzahan Bachchu, a prominent Bangladeshi writer and publisher, was shot dead by unidentified attackers. He was a former district general secretary of the Communist Party of Bangladesh. So there have been a large number of attacks on journalists in Bangladesh due to rising intolerance in the society. Next, former NIA. NIA stands for National Investigative Agency, right? It is the premier agency that is working against terrorism, financial terrorism in the country. So former NIA chief Sharad Kumar, who is a 1979 batch IPS officer, was appointed as the new vigilance commissioner in probity watchdog, that is the CVC, right? CVC otherwise was formed in the year 1964. However, with the passing of CVC Act, right, Central Vigilance Commission Act, in 2002, CVC became a statutory body, right? Now basically CVC has been founded to work against the corruption in the government. Next, veteran journalist and rising Kashmir editor Mr. Sujat Bukhari was shot dead by unidentified gunmen outside the newspaper's office in the heart of Srinagar. Next, sports. Anu Kumar from Uttarakhand clinched gold in the men's 800 meters at the 2018 Asia Junior Athletics Championship, which were held in Gifu in Japan. Next, Ashish Jakhad created a new national under 20 record to clinch gold medal in hammer throw at the 2018 Asian Junior Athletics Championship in Gifu, Japan. Next, in women's cricket, Bangladesh team won the Asia Cup T20 tournament by defeating India in the final. Next, the 23rd FIFA World Cup 2026 will be hosted by USA, Canada and Mexico. This tournament will be unique because it will be the first one to feature 48 teams after FIFA approved expansion from the current 32 team format. Next, Dawit Murli Kumar of Gujarat secured gold in men's 10,000 meter race at the Golden Spike meeting in Leiden, the Netherlands. Next, India's national football team lifted the 2018 Intercontinental Cup football title by defeating Kenya in the finals held in Mumbai. Next is Maria Bueno, a Brazilian tennis great who won 3 Wimbledon singles title and 4 at the US Open in 1950s and 60s and helped usher in modern women's tennis, died at the age of 78 years. So with regard to news items like this, you might be asked, with which sport was Miss Maria Bueno associated with? The answer in this case would be tennis. And then another variation would be, the tennis great Maria Bueno hailed from which country? In this case, the answer would be Brazil. Right? Next, Miss Mithali Raj became the first Indian cricketer to score 2000 runs in T20 international cricket. She achieved the landmark during India's 7 wicket win over Sri Lanka in Women's Asia Cup T20 at Kuala Lumpur. Next, New Zealand women's cricket team posted the highest ever total in one day internationals by scoring 490 for 4 against Ireland in 50 overs. Next, Rafael Nadal, a Spanish lawn tennis player, claimed his 11th French Open title when he defeated Austrian Dominic Thiem. Next, Shikhar Dhawan became the first ever Indian batsman to score a century in the first session of a test match, joining the illustrious ranks of Sir Don Bradman, Victor Trumper, Majid Khan and David Warner. Next, Simona Halep from Romania won her first Grand Slam at the 2018 French Open tennis tournament when she defeated Sloane Stephens. Sloane Stephens is from USA. Now again, this news also becomes important because Simona Halep has won her first Grand Slam ever, right? Again, her country of origin is also important. Next, some miscellaneous news items. Firstly, the World Blood Donor Day was observed on June 14th across the globe with the theme, Be There for Someone Else, Give Blood, Share Life. Next, World Day Against Child Labor was observed on June the 12th with the theme, Generation Safe and Healthy. Now, it is advisable that you keep remembering these days whenever you see our current affairs videos or whenever you come across them. It will become very difficult for you to remember them at one go. So it's important that you keep learning them as you encounter them in your preparations. Next, the 44th edition of the G7 Summit 2018 was hosted by Canadian Prime Minister Mr. Justin Trudeau in Quebec on June 8th. G7 is a group of seven countries which includes the developed countries with the highest GDP. Next, the 18th edition of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization summit was held in Qingdao, China. The summit concluded with the adoption of Qingdao Declaration, which calls for implementing a three-year plan to combat terrorism, separatism and extremism. The SCO was formed in the year 2003 with the following members. First is China, then Russia, then Kazakhstan, next Kyrgyzstan, next Tajikistan, and lastly Uzbekistan. Right, so it is a 7-member union. Right, now it has been further expanded, so 2 new members have been added in this in 2017, that is India and Pakistan. Right, so 7 plus 2, now it is a 9-member union. India and Pakistan have joined in 2017 as full-time members. Next, the World Oceans Day was celebrated on June the 8th, like every year. The 2018 theme was preventing plastic pollution and encouraging solutions for a healthy ocean. Next, the Fuego volcano, it's an active stratovolcano. Stratovolcano is a type of volcano in Guatemala. Guatemala is a country which is located in Central America, basically the small strip of land between North America and South America. It erupted violently and buried several villages, killing over 99 people. Next, the first official World Bicycle Day was observed by UN on 3rd June 2018. Next, the World Milk Day was observed by the Food and Agriculture Organization on June the 1st to recognize the importance of milk as a global food. The theme in India was Drink, Move, Be Strong. Next, the 106th Indian Science Congress will be held at Lovely Professional University, which is located in Jalandhar in the state of Punjab, from 3rd to 7th January 2019. Next, the Union Cabinet approved the nomination of Union Home Minister as the ex-officio chairman of the Northeastern Council. So the Northeastern Council was formed under the NEC Act of 1971. So thus it is a statutory body which consists of governors and chief ministers of all the 8 Northeastern states as its members. Next, United States government approved a deal to sell the Indian military 6 AH-64E Apache attack helicopters for $930 million. So again, you might get a question that from which country is India purchasing Apache attack helicopters from. Next, the 22nd edition of the trilateral naval exercise, that is Malabar 2018, was held between India, Japan and United States from June 6th till 15th. This is again very important. Next, India will host the first military exercise of the BIMSTEC. BIMSTEC is a short form for Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multi-Sectoral Technical and Economic Cooperation. Basically, it is a group consisting of countries surrounding the Bay of Bengal. The group focusing on counter-terrorism on September 2018 in Pune. Next, the Ministry of Women and Child Development launched hashtag Yoga for 9 to 5, a contest focused on generating awareness regarding benefits of yoga at the workplace for women. Next, the Union government gave its final clearance to Kaleshwaram lift irrigation project in Telangana to be built across the river Godavari. Next, the biopic The Making of the Mahatma was screened in South Africa to commemorate the 125th year of Mahatma Gandhi's Satyagraha. The biopic is based on the novel Apprenticeship of a Mahatma, which was written by Miss Fatima Mir. Next, India was ranked 118th among 175 countries in the End of Childhood Index 2018, which is issued by Global Child Rights Group Save the Children. Next, the Indian Navy evacuated 38 stranded Indians from the Socotra Island in Yemen, where they were stranded for nearly 10 days after a severe cyclonic storm called Mekunu. Right? The names are important. It hit the area. So that is all from this presentation. Thank you so much.